So that will bring to the line Grant Downing, the New Zealander, now racing out of Southern California, and Matt Hagan. Remember the great drama of last year? Well, this gives us a chance to go behind the scenes and all access with Matt Hagan.
You work better on less sleep, though. Think better. I think your mind's clearer.
It's killing me.
You're clearer when you're cloudy.
That's hard to believe.
Got a whole tire there, huh?
Yeah.
Where do you want it? Which side?
Either side.
Either side.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. There you go, buddy. Hope you have fun today, okay, man? Thanks a lot.
This weekend.
All right. Well, happy birthday, man. That's great.
25th wedding.
That's a good deal. Well, happy anniversary.
Yeah.
There you
Thank
go.
You very cool. much.
Thanks
a lot.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
All right.
How you doing?
And just like anchovies on a pizza, there is still a bad taste in the mouth of Matt Hagan, the guy who gave up the championship in Funny Car to John Force on the last day. He's had three long reflective months, no doubt taking many antacids to think about it. But wait till you see the man in the diehard car. He's 30 pounds lighter. He's renewed, he's refreshed, and he is ready to try to chew up the competition in Funny Car once again, guys.
Yeah, he's got a great, smooth attitude, kind of the attitude of a guy who's been to that championship fight, arrived here last year in the lead, lost out to John Forrest, where there is no chance.
Guys, over in the far lane, Grant Downing's having a real bad time trying to get his car started. They've used three different starting mechanisms, and they still can't get it going.
Still silent for Grant Downing's car. Not in the field.
They're chaining the starter motor to try to get that thing to spin over. Obviously, they can't get that engine to spin over. There's no way they're going to be able to start it. What happens is a drive gear in the front of that pulley, it's got to go in there and engage that to spin the engine over. That might be part of the problem.
Matt Hagan shows that he's ready, completes his burnout. They continue to wait for Grant Downing.
Now, Rich Stewart will give them a certain amount of time to get this thing started, but they cannot hold up Matt Hagan. So if they can get it started here shortly, if they shorten up their burnout and back up, Rick will let them go. If not, Rick will tell them, no, we're going to give Matt Hagan a single. Look like Graham Light might have already made that call.
Helen, as Matt Hagan brings that car back, guys, I can tell you, I went down to West Palm Beach to Palm Beach International Raceway for the testing, preseason testing, and watched all of these guys. Everybody ran so well, including Matt Hagan. And I asked him, you know, they talk about champions all the time. You got to go through losing a championship before you can learn how to win one. When you hear me say that, I asked him, how do you react to that? He said, Dave, quite honestly, it pisses me off. We are getting after it this year. We learned a lot. We're going to try to prove it here on the racetrack in 2011.
I tell you, the one thing I love about Matt Hagan, though, last season, he was very focused. I mean, all season long, he really did not make any mistakes in the driving compartment. Thursday, he came out, the car was off a little bit, the thing went out there and rattled the tires, and Matt backpedaled it, got that 12th and final time to carry over, which put him in 13th position right now with that 4:36. Right now, this car, we know it makes a ton of horsepower. It's your national record holding Funny Car. So if they get this thing hooked up, they're going to have it backed off a little bit, but it should still make a pretty nice pass.
Whoa.
Oh, that's surprising.
Well, not the pass we were looking for. Certainly not the one that Matt Hagan was. He stays with a 4:67 in 13th.
This is a surprise because we're talking about the shake zone right about there. They made it through there very nicely, but when they're applying the clutch, it just did not hold up the racetrack. Went up in tire smoke, and at that point, you saw Matt Hagan just shut off. But that car was very aggressive early. I thought it was going to make it, but it just didn't hold.